Cheer about for all the animal activists out there as the central government on 28th of November came up with a proposition that puts a blanket ban on entertainment provided by animals anywhere and everywhere. Going forward, hopefully if it gets turned into a law, then animals will not be seen entertaining us, mankind, at circuses, exhibitions, as well as even religious ceremonies. Now, there are two different viewpoints to this. On one hand, all the animal activists are simply loving it. They have given it a thumbs up. On the other hand, those whose life relies on animal entertainment are complaining about that. We'll take both the perspectives on our show this morning and to discuss this further. First up on my left, I have Ruchira, who's the owner of Cafe de Loco, which is a wonderful cafe in the heart of Hyderabad, wherein you can see a lot of animals, interact with them while you're having a good time there. Thank you so much for joining us, Ruchira.
Thank you so much for calling me. Thank you so much.
Pleasure is all ours. On to her left, we have Hemant, who happens to be Ruchira's only husband, and he's also the co-owner of the cafe, and he has been spending almost, 12 to 13 years in Hyderabad now.
Yes.
Originally from Delhi.
From Delhi.
Wonderful having you in our studio, Hemant.
Thank you.
Last but not the least, I have Shreya, who's an advocate and also an animal activist, and who I'm guessing should be delighted with this proposition that has been tabled by the government.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Very first happy. Up, let me take your thoughts. Going on for more than 2 decades.
It has.
Shreya, I would like to just stay with you on that thought. For now, we have another advocate who's joining us all the way from Delhi, Anupam Tripathi. Anupam, thank you so much for taking your time and joining us on this heated argument that we are having with regard to animals and their rights. Very quickly, what are the legal provisions? I have somebody from Chennai, Mr. Muralidharan, who argues that banning is not the solution because you ban them and then their monetary value disappears and then they are not taken care of. What are your thoughts? What are the legal provisions?
Yeah, sure, Ravi, thank you so much for giving me the opportunity. Murali is a dear friend, but sometimes he can be extreme. You see, all I say is
this. I think this morning he has been fairly extreme. Yeah, all right, go on.
Yes, but you know, there are always two sides to every argument. And as far as I'm concerned, I welcome this ban. 28th December, you know, there's another 30 days to go. 28th December is when it becomes final, hopefully.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a good step, it's a progressive step taken by the government to finally, you know, consider all the cruelties that were being meted out to these animals in the circuses.
Right.
And it's high time that the ban was put in place.
Mm. Now, when you talk about Murali's perspective, Murali is of the thought that these animals are not taken care of. Once the ban is imposed, they are left alone, and after that, they are even alienated from their communities. They will have depression, they will die because there will not be adequate food, and so on and so forth. Some of them valid arguments. Yes, I do understand that there is no step after the ban in terms of how is it that you'll rehabilitate these animals? How is it that you'll take care of them? So I think instead of arguing about the ban, what we should do is focus on the solutions ahead. Would you agree?
Yes, Ravi, I would agree. That's what, you know, I would say that, you see, there are two aspects post the ban as well. Those aspects would be, the rehabilitation of the animals, as well as these people working in the circuses.
Mm-hmm.
You see, the circuses as it is, you know, with every passing day, they're not doing too well.
Right.
They are struggling.
Right.
And they're one source of income. Or entertainment used to be through these animals, who they would of course torture,
right?
In order to train.
I think I get your perspective. You're talking about their right to livelihood, which is being affected because all this while they have been doing only this. They know only one job.
Yes, that's one. And the second is that the animals also we have to consider. You see, once the ban comes into place, what happens with these animals? We have to look at the aspect of rehabilitation of these animals. Where do they go?
Right.
Because in India currently, you see, these shelters, etc., are terrible.
Right.
They are terrible places even for dogs and cats.
Correct.
They're not being looked after well enough.
Right.
What happens to these animals is also something that has to be gone into.
Right.
Having said that, the ban per se is good for the circuses, because just imagine a tiger dancing to your tunes, or an elephant dancing to your tunes. It's not something that naturally comes to these animals.
Not just a tiger or an elephant, even a dog also. Why should the dog dance to your tunes? Yeah, in fact, the masters, the pet parents, actually dance to the dog's tunes. That's the kind of love and affection that we have for them.
To entertain people,
right?
And that too for a commercial value.
Right.
So I welcome this ban. This is a great step.
Right.
But let us see and ensure that it actually happens, because it's still to become final. These are only proposed rules.
Right.
And let's see what happens.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for those wonderful insights. Anupam, you were great. Unfortunately, that's all the time that we have, ladies and gentlemen, on this discussion. Very quickly, I want to understand what